Assassin's Creed Mirage is right around the corner and I can't wait. We are finally at the point now where we've seen a substantial amount of gameplay and cutscenes, and it looks like it's shaping up to be something we can actually look at and say, that's Assassin's Creed. I mean, I could be wrong and I've expressed my concerns in this video shown on screen now, but overall, it sounds like the game writer and creative director understand the DNA of an Assassin's Creed game. And although we barely saw much in the gameplay presentation, what we did see looks solid. So in this video, I'm going to be presenting 5 things that I want to see in Assassin's Creed Mirage. Starting with number 5, Unity style customization. As flawed as AC Unity is as a game, it has many redeeming qualities that, if perfected, could have made for a great entry in the series. Player customization being a notable aspect. The level of customization was intricate and in-depth. The ability to tailor Arno to your playstyle was unmatched when it came to other AC titles. I would even go as far as to say it was more complex than the RPG games. In Mirage, you can see Basim wearing one robe here and a different or upgraded robe here. It's evident that there will be a level of customization in the game, so with that said, let's hope it's as deep as AC Unity. At number 4, it's a dense open world. Now, I'm not talking about a huge open world. Maps in games don't have to be massive in order to achieve the Exile stamp of approval. To me, a perfect open world can be any size, small or large. It's what's in the open world that makes it what it is. The open world of Night City in Cyberpunk 2077 is by no means massive, but the city itself contains so many intricacies that you can easily get lost in. It presents the feeling of grandeur by the way the world is designed. That's what I want for Baghdad. I want to be able to get lost in the city, sidetracked into side streets, and then in said side street, I want to find a side activity or small story that I wouldn't have stumbled across otherwise. That's not me saying that massive open worlds don't do this as good or even better than smaller open worlds. The Witcher 3 is the perfect example of a colossal open world that is packed with meaningful content. I do a deeper dive into my perfect open world for an Assassin's Creed game in this video right here, and I'll link any video I mention in the description below. Number 3 is an evolving parkour system. So my idea for this was actually sparked by playing Star Wars Jedi Survivor. As you progress throughout the story, the protagonist Cal will encounter profound moments that trigger memories that then unlock new abilities. This boosts character development alongside varying gameplay by switching up the pace. It's a great way to elevate and evolve gameplay hand in hand with story. We know that Basim will face an identity crisis as he goes from feeling lost to understanding and finding a way to cope with his past incarnation as one who came before. Having Basim gain new skills as he refines his assassin artistry, along with learning who he once was, could be the perfect setup to keep the gameplay fresh, engaging, and a standout in the AC series. AC2 did this with parkour by introducing Climb Leap, a subtle feature that was a game changer. Literally, it changed the game. It's a video game changer. It made you take an approach to climbing slightly differently whilst not making you throw everything you've learned away. I think Mirage should set up a well-balanced parkour system that requires you to think about what steps to take and when. The player should be able to master the mechanic as they play, along with an evolution of the system throughout the duration of the game. Number 2 is narrative that accurately parallels the Secret War storyline with Basim's personal conflict. The DNA of Assassin's Creed always puts the Assassin's versus Templar conflict at the forefront and weaved the rest in accordance to that. In the Ezio trilogy, the writing perfectly paralleled Desmond with his ancestor. Mirage is set up to portray the classic AC formula, but with a spin. This is the perfect opportunity to parallel Basim's struggle for identity with his dedication to the Hidden Ones, and how certain beliefs of the Creed conflict his own perception on freedom. As he learns more about his past self, his opinions change on what he sees as peace and freedom, which might differ from that of his mentor, Roshan. This would lend into Basim's development as a protagonist, push the story forward at a steady pace, and help the player to view and understand the war between factions in a new yet familiar way. I talk about the potential for story writing in Mirage in the video shown on screen. And at number 1, it's the soundtrack. Music is present in media not just to sound cool. Music can elicit any chosen emotion, immerse the listener within the scene or setting, and music can even be used to represent a character's own feelings and emotion. Music is a device that takes a person from watching or playing something to becoming immersed in a living, breathing world. The first Assassin's Creed game soundtrack was uncanny and brooding at times, whilst elegant and inviting in other areas. The music conveyed the vibe of the game, unsettling music to transmit the feeling of uncertain times throughout the Holy Land, along with the deceivingly open arms of the Templars. Assassin's Creed Revelations has a grand and epic soundtrack. Revelations is a story of grandeur, the conclusion to an epic saga between two iconic characters. The game amplifies this through its soundtrack. In my opinion, Assassin's Creed Mirage's soundtrack should be an ambiguous score that has a sound of uncertainty. Unconventional music that can at times be erratic to show Basim's conflicted emotions within himself and with the Creed. The score for Baghdad could be epic to represent the true magnitude of the city, while the score for Alamut could be dark and twisted with clashing instruments to show that it's a mysterious fortified castle with hidden ones honing their assassin skills. So there you have it, my personal top 5 things I want to see in Assassin's Creed Mirage. Now I think if even half of what I mentioned is present in the game, then it could indeed be something quite special. Everyone's gonna have different ideas for their top 5, so please let me know your ideas in the comments and we can get a discussion going and build that AC community. I love you guys, mate. The Father of Understanding, guide us. I will see you soon. Goodbye.